It's Cash Dang and I'm rocking with Chi-Town Urban Radio.
You're there.
It's your boy Young Chi-Town, man.
What's going on, world? It's the big homie DJ JT the Donnie.
Girl Alana D.
Bridge Janae, aka Miss Lil Body.
Hey, I'm Zaza Satanica.
Tune in to Chi-Town.
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 Listening to Chi-Town
Urban Radio on UBM Jams.
Chicago Urban Radio.
Chi-Town Urban Radio, the best place to be at any day, really. It's the one and only DJ Malone. We still got my guy, Cash Daniels, into the building.
Yo. This Chicago.
What you, how you feeling today, man? How you feeling?
Feeling good, man. Feeling good.
So let me ask you a real question. Let me ask you something real. Now, you're doing this rap thing. Who would you like to work with? As far as, you know, artists go, who would you like to work with?
Actually... Andre 3000.
That's deep. I like that.
Yeah.
Okay. Producers. Who would you like to
Producers. I'm a go with either Dre or Kanye.
Dre or Kanye? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. That's decent though. That's decent. Kanye's a beast. But let me ask you this. If you had to pick one, who would you pick?
Dre.
Has that always been a long time ago, or just something? Hey, if you want to work with somebody, you got to work with the best.
I think I'm working with, and not just getting a beat from is different. When you're getting a lot more when you're working with Dr. Dre.
Now, as far as events, have you been doing any events lately, or what's been going on in your world?
I got an event coming up this weekend back in my hometown, Fremont, Ohio. Actually doing a event with this guy, Darren Falana from Canada.
Okay.
He's coming up nice, he real nice.
Okay.
We gonna be taking the stage.
Okay, definitely, man. So whenever you go to a show, cause I'm interested to see what kind of, how you go about doing your performance stuff, man. So if I go to a show, what am I expecting? What am I gonna see?
I got this dynamics. Chill at one moment, might jump out the roof the next moment. It's real spontaneous. You never know. It's the vibe. I go based off the vibe every time.
Definitely, man. Okay. Is it free to get in? Is it tickets? What can they do?
We got tickets for $15. And if you don't get a ticket, you go out the door, but it'll be $20.
Okay, definitely. Hey, look, black people. I'm talking to black people right now. Look, I'm tired of you guys just wanting to get in free all the time. Support the man. It's $15,
yeah.
Man.
$15. Yeah, we flying my man and his team from Canada.
Oh my God, man.
He's got a lot going on. So they want to come check him out too. You know, I'm gonna bring what I bring to the table, but he's also bringing something to the table as well.
Definitely. $15 to get in, man. That's on Saturday.
Yep.
Saturday,
October,
man.
15.
Make sure you guys be there. You need to be there, man. Hey, I wish I could come. I have to be here.
Oh yeah, you gotta do what you gotta do, man.
So, but you ever back in Chicago doing events? Get my line up.
Oh, I will be back.
So yeah, definitely, man. So, what do you think about this violent stuff? This like this police brutality. There's all types of crazy stuff. And you're from Ohio, so I would assume that you kind of get that type of. Not racism, but discrimination.
I mean, you being black in America, you're going to get a little bit of it wherever you at. Yeah. But luckily, I live in a small town, so, you know, we ain't got too much of the police brutality because, you know, we went to school with a lot of the police officers, you know, so they know.
Wow.
You know, it's kind of like you in a small town, everybody knows everybody, so it's a little more of a personal feel. But going to cities and seeing things, I understand.
I wish I had that privilege.
I know.
I must have it.
It's a blessing.
Definitely.
And people talk and think it's crazy that I went back to a small town because I've been around, but people be like, why do you keep coming back to this place?
Do you like being from a small town? Because I know some people, they hate it.
It's a job.
Definitely.
I'm there to make sure people that are there don't feel like they can't do whatever they want to do just because they're there.
Definitely, man. Let's talk about this new joint, man, you got, man. Just one thing. Tell me about this one thing, man.
it's, you know, it's one thing about me. It's like I'm just letting everybody know. One thing about me is the main thing is I'm determined and ain't nothing gonna stop me.
Hey man, that one thing about him is he's determined, and you can tell when I can tell when artists are really about something. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I talked to a good amount of artists. You came, you know, correct. You know what I'm saying? Yo, hey, how you doing, Malone? My name's Cass Daniels. You know, I'm from Ohio. You know, I got a couple stalkers underneath my belt. You know, I don't want them to call my phone lines and stuff like that. So, let's get into it right now, man. You want to break it?
Oh yeah. Here's one thing about me coming from my new project. And this, hey, let me just mention, this is the first time I'm dropping the name of my new project, and I was just about to drop it without letting people know that this is the first time on your show, man.
Oh, wow. So, today must be my birthday. So
yeah, you're special, man. Oh, you're special, man.
Hey, man, I like getting exclusive, man. So, definitely, man. So, we gonna talk about that. We gonna talk, man. Right. It's called One Thing About Me, man. Cass Daniels is in the building, CHITOWNURBANRADIO. Let's go! Hey, CHITOWNURBANRADIO, man. We here with Cass Daniels, man. We just played this joint. Hey, man. Hey, like I told you, I like the cadence, how you coming on to the song, to the joint. It's really spazzy, man. So, how did you come up with that?
Chilling, and my man's dropped the beat to me, and I'm like, I went right to work.
Definitely, definitely.
Went right to work.
We got a call on the line. Let's get the call in, man. Call him, man. Say your name. Where you calling from?
Johnson calling from Fremont, Ohio.
I can't hear you. Say it one more
time. This is Johnson calling from Fremont, Ohio.
Man, what up, what up?
What's going on, family?
Just going on. I'm going to tell you what a hard working man, most humble young man I've ever met in my life. I just want to call him congratulations and tell him that you're
going to
do work.
Appreciate it, man. I really do, fam.
Definitely, man. Hey, I appreciate you calling in, man. Anything else you want to plug or say anything?
Oh yeah, no doubt.
That's what it is, man. Hey, I appreciate you calling in, CHITOWNURBANRADIO, man. It's been a pleasure.
All right, thank you, man.
I'm waiting for one of your stalkers to call in, and we can figure out why she's talking.
That don't happen. That's all. I got my ducks in a row.
Oh, okay. Have you ever been in that situation before where it's like, you know, you get the girl to Yaki and she gets kind of crazy?
If any callers call, you would understand I got my ducks in a row.
Okay. We'll see.
So I ain't got nothing crazy happening.
Definitely, man. Hey, man. So talk to us about the project, man. What's going on with the project that you gave me the exclusive?
Well, you know, that was the first drop off of it, first song off of any other project, but it is called Not Just Another Vacation, and it's coming soon.
Okay.
But right now, I got Wild to the Bone, which dropped a few months back.
Okay.
I got these copies for you, but Not Just Another Vacation will be dropping soon, man. You'll get that as soon as it drops.
Okay. You got my email, so.
Oh, you got it. You got it.
Slide it in right there. Oh. With the one thing about me, is there a video to it, or can we expect it? What's going on with that?
Expect the video soon. I can't drop a date on how soon, but expect the video real soon. We shot it, and it's amazing. Shout out to Unknown Visions. Marcus Meets My Films.
Okay.
Amazing video work. It's going down.
How important is your music to you? Like, how important is your craft? Are you the type of person where, like, you're very nitpicky? This has to be this. This has to be that. How are you?
It has to get done. That's it.
Definitely.
And I mean, it's obviously quality over quantity, but gotta grind.
Definitely, man. Hey, man, we got Cass Daniels into the building. If you want to call in, 312-985-7834, man. The guy from Ohio, man, he brought these CDs, man. So you want to pass them out, man, and let people know that when we go back to the music break and talk to the fans, because I'm going to have you live, too.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to do some live stuff. I'm feeling very cheery today, man.
Oh, yeah, me too, man. Yeah.
Have you had any deep dish pizzas? Have you got the deep dish pizza?
Yes. Jared Dino's?
Yeah. Giordano's.
Let me correct me if however I pronounced it, but yeah, I had some of that and it was amazing.
Let me ask you a real deep question before we go back into the music break. If you could perform anywhere, where would it be at and why?
I would say selling out the Garden just because the impact Jay-Z had on hip-hop when he sold it out for saying he was retiring during the Black Album, because that was a major time in hip-hop.
Yeah, it was.
And he sold out the Garden and he was the first to do it from a hip-hop standpoint.
Yeah, it really was. So the Garden, so that's the goal right there.
Selling out the Garden a little bit, but there's a few festivals and things that I would want to get on too, like Coachella and things like that, but just venue-wise, I'll say the Garden.
Okay, definitely. All right, man, well, what we're going to do, we're going to go into a music break, we're going to come right back with Cass Daniels. We're going to play a game. We're going to come right back, man.
All right.
It's your boy, DJ Malone. Let's get into it. Let's go. DJ Malone, man. We're back here on CHITOWNURBANRADIO. We still got my guy, Cass Daniels, in the building.
Yo, my dog.
What's going on, G? How you feeling?
Still feeling good, man. Feeling real good. Glad to be here, man.
Are you full of that good, or are you just feeling good?
Oh, you know. Feeling good, you know.
Definitely, man. Hey, man, the number to call in is 312-985-7834. Hopefully, we can get some stalkers in this piece and, matter of fact, I want the delivery man to call me for some reason. Like, I want to feel special. Like, you know, I want to feel like a king. Like, okay, cool, Malone, what you need? I got you, bro. I'll come wherever you need, yo. I got you.
Yeah.
Hey, but that's how it goes, man. So, all right, so let me ask you this, man. Now, as long as you've been doing this rap game, what are some of the trials and tribulations that you had to go through?
Well, main thing, I mean, I was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. About four or five years ago now.
Oh wow.
And it says it's supposed to prevent mobility in you, but it hasn't done that to me very much. And I read an article that they called it the disease that shatters dreams, but that hasn't done that to me either, so.
Man, we gotta give a round of applause. Everybody clap in the studio. Hey. I said clap. Anyway.
The one hand clap.
Don't worry about him. Don't worry about him. Ugh. I am the master in here. He's just somebody that sits here. I allow him to be here. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, we got a caller on the line, man. I'm going to get this caller. Caller, man, say your name, where you calling from?
Hello, my name is Lauren Yurki. I'm calling from Springdale, Ohio.
How you doing? How you doing, mama? That's my mama.
That's right. I know, mama. You get it, mama. Hey, she's proud of herself. She's getting my son on the radio, man.
Got a car. Yeah.
Definitely, man. Definitely. Anything you want to say to him?
Excuse me?
Anything you want to say to him?
Oh, I love you and I'm proud of you.
Thank you and I love you too, mama.
Oh, that's so sweet. That's so sweet.
Yeah. Have a great day.
Well, thank you for calling in, mama.
I got the teary eye.
Right.
Yes.
We got another caller, man. Let's get this other caller. Caller, say your name. Where you calling from?
I'm calling from Toledo, Ohio.
Ohio, what
Toledo.
Up?
Toledo.
Yo.
What's up over there?
I'm kind of hungry. We got my guy, Cass Daniels, into the building, though.
Yeah, I know. What's up, Cass?
Oh, not too much.
You know who this is?
I'm listening, trying to make it out.
It's his family. I've been seeing you online. Christina, you ain't seen me in a long time.
Oh, yeah? How's it been?
Yep.
Oh.
I got family over in Chicago right now.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Definitely. Where at in Chicago?
Where at? They like right downtown. They're trying to recruit college kids to go over here to UT.
Okay, definitely, man. Well, I'm out south, so I'm out with the drillers and hitters. So, but it's okay though.
It's good to hear y'all's voice.
Yeah, good to hear you too.
Well, thank you for calling in.
All right.
How you gonna do it like that, man? GC called to support you. He's like, definitely. So when you live in this small town, do you feel like you have like a weight on your shoulders? Because once you make it like mega, I see you making it mega big. And once you make it mega big, do you feel like all of them catch, yo, you know, we went to high school to get a Joe, like, what's up, man? Let me cop 5 G's from, you know, you got it.
Yeah.
You know, you got it.
I feel like my good words and inspiration is enough for the city.
Real. That's real, though, man. That's real. Is there any inspiring words that you can give to an upcoming artist or upcoming rapper, whoever that's trying to get into the music game?
Don't give up, because I mean I've been doing this since I can remember, and I mean, just don't give up. Things start to happen if you just keep on going, don't stop.
Definitely, man, definitely. We do got KT Lasers in the building, man, all the way. You know, she's from Chicago, but she lives in Texas, so she came all the way out here to come rock with your boy. We got this guy. Let's talk about the topic of the day, man. I wanted to get to know a lot of people's inputs and different stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And my whole thing is, somebody brought this to my attention earlier, that if racism was reversed, let's say if whites were in slavery, would people be okay with that?
No. Not in the system. System we're in now, it won't. They won't be comfortable with it at all. It just won't work.
I'm gonna give you my input. Let's take your caller real quick, man. You got a lot of callers on, man. Caller, man, state your name, where you calling from.
My name is Craig. I'm calling from Cincinnati, Ohio.
Oh, yo, what's going on, big bro?
What up, Craig?
What up?
Craig.
Cash.
Definitely, man. Anything you want to say to Cash Daniels?
Yeah, I'm about to say what up. I see you doing big things, and I'm super excited for him.
Appreciation. I love you, bro.
I love you too. All right, I gotta get back to work though.
All right, all right,
man.
Get that money, man.
Make that paper.
Cut it.
All right. Yeah. Definitely. But yeah, back to my discussion. Before this rude something just interrupted me. I believe in equality. You know what I'm saying? I believe in being equal. So if like I don't go on the tick for tat type of deal, I believe that everybody should be equal. No matter if you're Asian, white, black, purple, brute, whatever.
Yeah.
Everybody's equal. That's
is
how
blue
I
people
feel.
Out here?
Huh?
Is blue people out here?
No, just shut up. Okay. Just shut up. Anyways, so as you know, this racism thing goes along, have you ever been into a situation where like you've been kind of discriminated on by the cops or by a higher authority?
Oh, yeah. I mean, just in a small town, I mean, you still get that. I mean, we're surrounded by all races and things in a small town. You know, bigger cities, it's a little, you know what I mean? You can stick to, you go to a part of town, you ain't, 9 times out of 10, you might not see too many of a different color, but in a small town, we surrounded. So, you know, some people comfortable being around brothers, some people ain't, you know, and I seen it all.
Definitely, man. I think in this day of age, what's the word I'm looking for? People are just so assumption to think something. But here's the thing, we all do it. People do it all the time. If I see a black guy in a hoodie walking down on 79th Street, I'm going the other side.
That's because it's 79th Street.
If I see a guy downtown, I'm going the other way.
No, you're not.
Look. Yes, I am.
You just said south side.
Exactly.
You ain't downtown.
Exactly.
You're going that way.
Exactly.
look. You ain't fooling me, Malone.
All right, so if I go downtown, if I see a black guy in hoodie, I ain't gonna go there.
I understand where those assumptions do come because, I mean, that's media play, though, at the same time, because the most innocent man in the world can get cold and want to wear a hoodie.
Yeah, hey, that's what it is.
I get cold sometimes.
Yeah, I bet you do, huh? Yeah. Did you play sports? You look like a jock type of guy. You look like a
I played sports. I played football coming up in high school and things, you know.
What were you?
Tailback.
Okay, definitely. I never played football. I played basketball. I was a point guard all day.
I ain't played much. That's why, you know, they ain't like that. I was too focused on rap music. They like, man, come on, you don't need to play.
So you said
I ain't play. They ain't mess with me like that. I ain't gonna lie.
Definitely.
I thank them for not playing as much make me focus on this music.
Definitely. Hey, man, that's what it is like there, man. Now, what was the biggest accomplishment that you had so far? Like, what was this? Yes, I'm in here, man. I'm on my way. I'm doing big things. What was that feeling that you got?
I'll say every time I bring my city out for an event, my whole city come out. It's real rewarding to see people come out and I'm gonna go back to the small town thing. There's hate everywhere, but in a small town you know the people's name, date, and everything, birthday, everything, where they live, everything, the people that's hating on you, because you know pretty much everything about everybody that you're living around.
Yeah, that's real though, man. Traveling, are you willing to travel? You want to go to New York?
We everywhere.
Okay, definitely.
We everywhere. 1 p.m. gets around.
Let's talk about that 1 p.m. Is that a movement or what's going on with that?
Yeah, it's the movement. It's the 100% movement. And, you know, 1 p.m. and 1 p.m. always comes on the clock.
Okay, it does. It really does.
It really does.
Unlike some people who have black people time.
1:15 for black people time.
1:15.
I'm gonna keep my comments to myself.
Anyway, I want to get back into your joint, but I want to do something with a twist real quick. If you allow me, man, I want to get your blessing real quick.
Okay.
All right, we're gonna do this. We're gonna play a song one more time. You want to introduce the track one more time?
One thing about me from Cash Day on the coming from the new project, not just another vacation.
We're going to talk about not just another vacation. I don't want to go on another vacation right now.
You need to hurry up and do it.
Anyways, let's go.
So,
you see how, see what I
he was gone for 3 months. I don't even know why he came back.
We're going to get back into the mix. We're going to come right back. He was the one and only CHITOWNURBANRADIO DJ Malone. Let's go.
This is Chicago.
With you, do you ever feel like when you get up, like say like when I was doing some rap and stuff, like I woke up out of my sleep in a hot sweat, I need to write down this verse or whatever.
On a fantasy ride.
Fantasy ride, right?
Really, I'm blessed to be in a situation where I can record like when I want. So when I feel like creative, I start recording and making a song. But there's lots of times where I think of something and I'll say, oh, I'll get to that, and it's gone. The thought's gone, but the next thought is even better, more genius, so I'm not even worried about the thought I just lost.
Definitely. While you're in Chicago, you haven't hit up any showcases or anything else like that?
I have not. Just been getting around seeing what there is to see, doing what there is to do, you know.
If you was to hit me up and told me that, I could at least, because I'm on 88.9 FM. So we could have, you know, you could have came up there and chilled. You know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah, man. I'm in the Midwest. I'm not too far.
Yeah.
I'm in the Midwest. I'll be back.
I know a couple of DJs out there. I'm gonna make a couple phone calls.
Oh yeah.
And look out for my guy Cash Daniel. You know, his stalkers called in and he just treated like this girl on the phone and stuff like that. And it was kind of crazy because I didn't understand what happened. Like
he just being extra. He ain't do nothing.
Yeah, I ain't do nothing wrong. I don't believe I did anything.
He ain't
wrong.
Do nothing.
Let me ask you this, then. Let's play a game. Matter of fact, this is what we're gonna do. I got this one of these joints right here. Mm-hmm. Your joint. It's called 1 p.m. on a money. Or on the money. Well, how do you say it?
1 p.m. on a Monday.
On a Monday. Okay.
On a Monday.
I'm nearsighted, so I can't really see it from all the way right here. I apologize.
Oh, Monday. Good.
Please don't kill me because I don't need nobody. You see what I'm talking about?
Yeah, we can talk.
You want to go ahead and introduce the joint and tell the people about it or whatever?
1 p.m. on a Monday from Ohio to the Bone.
That's it?
You know, they gonna listen to it, then, you know, you probably want to talk about it a little more after you listen to it.
Let's go ahead and listen.
Other extra stuff.
I wish you
know,
I wish
everything.
You had a microphone.
Play the song. Thank you.
Whatever.
Come on.
Here we go. Chitown Urban Radio. Let's go. Yeah, who is it?
Who is that?
You calling me? Block. Yeah.
Okay.
Scream.
Shut up, Chitown. Chitown Urban Radio, man. Hey, man, I really like that joint. That song has like a southern twang to it, man.
Yeah.
We still got my guy, man, Cass Daniels, man. Talk to him, man.
And that song kind of goes back to questions you was asking earlier about how I feel about race and
That's real deep stuff, though, man. I like that, man. And in a little bit, we're gonna have KT Lace come in and she's gonna sit down with us and talk and stuff like that. So you should network with. You got so many people. You got a jackass right here.
You already know, boy. I swear to God.
You got a upcoming mogul right here, man. You got a model. You got DJs in here. You got all types of people in here. But don't worry about it. If he gives you a business card,
what's talking about jackass? Hold on, you just called me a jackass. Excuse me, sir. We already meet, right? We be breeding everything, okay? Forget him.
Anyway,
you wanted them back out. They get lost all the time.
So this is on the Ohio to the Bone.
That was on Ohio to the Bone.
Okay, so is this on that pair for where can the people find it?
You can find it everywhere, almost Spotify, Google Play, Apple Music, stuff like that.
Pandora. Definitely.
Yeah, Pandora has that. So
what do you think of
the Cash Dance station over there?
What do you think about the streaming era? Like the streaming stuff is like I'm cool with it, but how do you feel, man? What's your thoughts?
Consumer based, it's amazing. On the other end, they got kinks to work out, but it's getting better and better. And they changed the rules a little bit just because Chance dropped a streaming only album, and now you can win a Grammy from just a streaming only album.
That's crazy.
So it's a possibility. That guy right there is breaking the barriers for cats like me coming up don't want to go through that.
Definitely, man. As far as paperwork, how important is paperwork, though, man? Because I tell artists all the time, Malone, I got this hot track, you play it on the radio, and it's not copyrighted. I had this happen one time. Dude didn't tell me that it wasn't copyrighted. So he comes on, I was on 88.9 at that time. So I'm playing the drone or whatever, and I break it and do whatever I need to do with it. And then 2 weeks later, he says somebody copied my style and took the same exact song. I said, well, get him for copyright infringement. He said, I don't know how to do that. Well, then you just lost the song, buddy.
You gotta be on top of your business. Really? Gotta be. When I decided that music was gonna be a career, I took time to figure out what the business was. Because you can't get into a business if you don't know what the business is.
Real. That's real though, man. Give it a Facebook and Twitter where everything where they can find you.
Pretty much everything will be at It's Cash Daniel, or you can go to www.1pmthemovement.com.
I like that you have a website. A lot of people don't have a website.
You got one. I got one. You probably got one too. Man.
Why are you even talking? You know what? I just pretended that his mic was off so I can
drop bombs.
Anyways, Ohio to the Bone, man. This is not a vacation. So when can we expect that? When are we looking at that?
Mid to late November, maybe.
Okay, so it's dropping.
Coming,
really
it's soon. Coming. It's coming. Okay. Fall.
Okay.
In the fall, sometime this season.
Any features on there, or is it just you?
The only feature is from my man's from Dayton. Cutty P.
Okay, definitely, definitely then, man. Hey, I'm excited, man. I gotta get my hands on things, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, you know.
You will have your hands on
your
it.
Your hands on things.
Before it completely dropped. Just because you, man.
Definitely,
just
man.
You, I'll make sure you get it.
He ain't special.
Well,
I ain't even get one.
I'm talking about the new one though.
You didn't gonna give him one like he's important or something.
I am important.
Yeah,
sir.
All right.
Thank you.
Man, we're having a good time here, man. Now we're gonna play a game. I've been procrastinating it, but we're gonna do it now. The time is over.
All right.
So let me ask you this. Now, I'm freaking out right now. I had some of that good before I came in.
Oh, just support.
Appreciate
it. What a trick.
Go ahead and get back to the show, man.
I'm freaking out because I had some before I came in, so you got to excuse me. All right, so whenever I ask you questions, you just tell me whatever comes to mind. So I might say, you know, ice cream or bananas. You tell me which one you like better.
All right, cool.
Tupac or Biggie?
You gonna start with that? You gonna start with that right there. Like, that's how you gonna start?
Yeah.
Well,
real bold.
I mean, I'm gonna go Pac. Okay. If you don't give me an ultimatum to just choose off the rip, I'm gonna go with Pac just for the simple fact of what his music will cause. It'll cause people moving forward more than Biggie's music, but Biggie's dope, don't get me wrong, but I'm talking about just beyond the music.
Yeah, he was...
That's why I gotta go with Pac, because beyond the music.
Pac was more of an influence, you know, he was a leader, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, he was really about something. Not knocking Biggie, but Pac was really, you know, he was really about improving the neighborhood and stuff like that. So let's go ahead
Major
with
key.
Another hard one. Nelly or Twister?
That's
not fair.
What?
But I'm gonna go with Twista.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Twista.
Even though I like Country Grammar and all that, you know, Nelly was cool, but you know, I'm gonna go with Twista, man.
Okay. Let's see. Jill Scott or Lauryn Hill?
Lauryn Hill.
You can probably line Lauryn Hill up with a lot, and she's gonna. You gotta go with Lauryn.
Okay, let's do this. Lauryn Hill, Erykah Badu.
I'ma still go with Lauryn
Hill. Really? Really?
Erykah Badu has more work out there, but the Miseducation of Lauryn Hill was probably one of the most classic joints to touch music.
Yeah. Alright, now here go a twist. Here goes a real good twist. Andre 3000 or Big Boy?
Oh, I'm gonna go with Andre, yeah. Let's go with Andre.
All day! I'm talking. Alright, let's do this then. Let's bring it back to Pac. Andre 3000 or Tupac?
What?
You look like one of the tough ones out there, but I'm gonna respect the dead, and I'm gonna say Pac, man.
Oh man. Andre was dope though. Man.
I mean, I like
that's hard.
That's hard because I would say Andre 3000 any day, Tupac any day, but just right now I'm just feeling like Pac.
Okay, Pac is everything. Hey, I ain't mad at you, man. I would probably pick Pac. I love Andre 3000. Oh, his wordplay is just like phenomenal to me.
Anyways, as
you know, coming into Chicago, man. Now, if you would like to work with anybody from Chicago, who would it be? Who besides Kanye? Besides
Chance.
Chance, yes.
Chance, man. What about he doing? Just because he's real dope and the stuff that he's doing. Like I said, they changed the rules of the Grammys for that guy. They ain't gonna say it, but that's who they changed the rules for.
What about, King Louie? You ever heard of King Louie?
King Louie, I heard his name a few times.
He does that, he's real big for that B.O.N., that Live and Die in Chicago. Mm-hmm. If I had the clean version, I'll play it, but I ain't got the clean version.
I went to high school with
that. You know, the FEC, they come on me all the time. They're like, Malone, you can't be saying some of the things. Because I be saying some wild stuff.
Yes, he does.
I be saying some wild. I had the 16-year-old guy. he had a deep voice, like a real deep voice like mine. So I was like, I just wanna know when your balls drop. And I ain't thinking nothing of it, I just wanted to know. Like, I went to puberty, you're going through.
Yeah, he going through at the moment.
Well, definitely, man. Any shout outs, anything you wanna give to your stalkers, your lovers, your supporters?
Shout out to the 1PM movement, man. Everybody that's involved know who they are. Shout out to all of them. They're a blessing to my life, and I thank them for everything that they do.
Definitely, man. And big shout outs to your team, man, right here. Your team right here, man. So big shout outs to everybody, man. I appreciate you coming in, man, and supporting the boys, man.
Oh, yeah.
It's I like when people really come and rock with me, and you came from a different state. So okay.
Finish talking, but heads is my hand.
When the hand goes up, your mouth is, you know, the rest. You know, when people come from a different state, it really means something to me. And like, you know, I told my guy, I was like, man, we gotta make sure that this dude is good, man. You know what I'm saying? Because you know, we're coming from out of state, you know, we want to make you feel special, make you feel like a king, man.
Oh, yeah, man, I appreciate it. I really do appreciate that.
So, every time you come back here, it's family.
Oh, yeah.
Saturday, man, $15 to get in, $20 at the door.
$20 at the door.
Look, black people.
Do not come to the door talking about, I ain't got it.
Don't let nobody in for free. That's your money.
That's your money.
That's why I be trying to explain to these artists. It's like, whenever you got an event and the promoter tells you that you bring 10 paying people in, I'll give you a cut from this. But see, the thing is, us black people, they don't want to pay. They don't want to pay $10, $15.
Well, I know him. I can get in for free because I know who he is.
No. If you know me, support me.
Straight up.
Straight like that, man.
Uh-huh.
Since you like Pac so much, we're going to go ahead and play a pop joint and end the interview with that. And then we're going to play some of your joints, man, because I'm going to run through them, man. I'm like, I'm going to go do the train on them. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, come on, sir. I appreciate
you. Hit them with the breaking news, too, man, about that the BET and the MTV joint.
I'm going to let you talk about it. That ain't me. That's on you. So, give it the Facebook one more time. Give it the Facebook, Twitter, everything where they can find you at, man. Run down everything, man.
Everything will be at It's Cash Daniel and www.1pmthemovement.com.
Definitely, man. Ohio to the bone. Make sure you guys get it. It's real easy to go. Just, you know, look up Cash Daniels and you'll find it, man. Ohio to the bone. It's on everywhere.
Ohio to the bone is all over the internet.
Everything.
You can find it.
I really, really do like, you know, when I heard that joint, number 10, the 1 p.m. on a Monday, man. Why not a Tuesday or Wednesday or something like
that? You know, I mean, just Monday is back to work type, you know, and at 1 p.m., most of the time you in the mode of work at 1 p.m. on a Monday.
Definitely.
And that's kind of the talk at 1 p.m. on a Monday. You're having a conversation, you know, it might get deep or something like that.
Real. Not another vacation.
Yep.
Well, I'm
not just another vacation. It's coming and you will have it.
November, man. Notice how I say, once again, you want to get to know this man.
Yes, sir.
Notice how I say that, man. Make sure you guys follow him. We're going to be promoting this stuff here, man. That's not even a given. We got my girl, KT Legs, about to come up. We're going to go ahead and play some Tupac since he picks Tupac over Biggie and Andre 3000. Oh, my God. And, you know, we have.
Hey, get out your feelings and play.
Thug Life.
Anyways, Chi-Town on the radio.
You jamming to Chi-Town?